फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू बैंक एग्जाम कैफे। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द प्रॉब्लम्स फ्रॉम अरिथमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन। वी हैव सीन द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ इंट्रोडक्टरी अरिथमेटिक प्रॉब्लम्स इन विच वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट टर्म, व्हाट इज द लास्ट टर्म, and we have seen what is the common difference, and also we have seen what is the meaning of the arithmetic progression. Now this is the part 2, and we will see few more questions. And here is the first question on the screen. If k plus 1, 3k and 4k plus 2 be any three consecutive terms of an AP, then find the value of k. Friends, here it is given that these three terms are the consecutive terms of an AP. There is a difference between the consecutive numbers and the consecutive terms of an AP. Consecutive numbers means the difference between the successive numbers will be 1, 21, 22, 23. These are the consecutive numbers, but the consecutive terms of an AP means the first term of that arithmetic progression, second term of that arithmetic progression, third term of arithmetic progression. Here in the consecutive numbers, the difference will be always 1. But in the arithmetic progression, the difference may differ between the consecutive terms. It will depend on the questions or the arithmetic progression that is given. So here these three are the consecutive terms of an AP, and we have to find the value of k. So the three consecutive terms are k plus 1, then 3k, and the third term is 4k plus 2. 4k plus. So these are the three terms, and since we know that the difference between the successive terms is always equal, means suppose this is first term A1, this is the second term A2, and this is the third term A3, then A2 minus A1, that will be equal to A3 minus A2, because in the arithmetic progression the common difference is there. It means the A2 minus A1 and A3 minus A2, A4 minus A3, all these differences will be equal. So here we get that A2 minus A1, that is equal to A3 minus A2. And so this will be K plus 1, 3K minus K plus 1 minus K plus 1, which is equal to A3 minus A2, that is 4K plus 2 minus 3K. So this will be 3K minus K, this will become minus 1, which is equal to 4K minus 3K, that will be K plus 2. So 3K minus K, that will be 2K minus 1, which is equal to k plus 2. And now here take k to the other side, so you will get 2k minus k, so 2k minus k will be k, which is equal to take 1 to other side, so it will become plus 1, so 2 plus 1, that will be equal to 3. And since we have got the value of k as 3, highlight this, never forget to highlight the important things. And therefore, at the end, you will write the answer. That answer, the required value of k, the required value of k is equal to 3. Now let us see the second question, and that second question is on the screen. If A, B and C, find A, B and C such that the following numbers are in AP: A, C, 7, B, 23 and C. Here the given AP is that A, 7, B, 23 and C, and we have to find the value of A, B and C. So friends, here once again we see that this is the arithmetic progression, and therefore the difference between these two will be same. The difference between these two will be same. Difference between these two will be same, and the difference between these two will be same, because the common difference in the arithmetic progression is always same. So here we get that 7 minus A, A2 minus A1, that is 7 minus A, which is equal to, here it is 23, or you can write as B minus 7 also, so B minus 7. Now if you solve this, you will get it as, it will be like this. So if you take B to this side, it will be minus A minus B, which is equal to minus 7, take 7 to this side, so that will become minus 7. So this will be minus A minus B is equal to minus 14, and if you change the sign throughout the equation, then you will get it as A plus B, which is equal to 14. And let this be the equation number 1. A plus B, that is equal to 40. Now here you get that B at 23 and C. So this term minus this term, that is 23 minus B, also 23 minus B, that is equal to C minus 23. C minus 23. So take C to this side, so it will be minus B minus C, which is equal to, take this 23 to this side, this will be 20 minus 23, and this will also become minus 23. And so if you change the sign throughout the equation, so it will become B plus C, which is equal to 23 plus 23, that will be 46. Let this be equation number 2. Now here the first equation is A plus B is equal to 14, and the second equation is B plus C is equal to 46. Now friends, here again, if you take this difference B minus 7 and 23 minus B, that difference will also be equal. So we can take this as B minus 7 also, B minus 7, which is equal to 23 minus B, 23 minus B. So if you take B to this side, that will be B plus B, and it will be 2B, which is equal to, take 7 to the other side, so it will be 23 plus 7, so that will be 30, and therefore 2 ones are 2, 2 15s are 30, and so B will be equal to 15. You have got the value of B, so highlight it. Now put this value of B in the equation 1, so that you will get the value of A. So putting, so put this in equation number 1. Put in equation 1. So we will get A plus B, that is B is 15, so A plus 15, that is equal to 14. And take 15 to the other side, take 15 to the other side, so it will be minus 15, so 14 minus 15, that will be minus 1. So A is equal to minus 1, and so highlight this because you have got the second equation. Now we will move further, put the value of B in the equation number 2, so that you will get the value of C. So put in equation number, so from 2, what we will get? B, B is what? It is 15, so 15 plus C, which is equal to 46, and therefore C will be equal to, and so I solve it here, C, that is equal to 46 minus 15, and 46 minus 15, and therefore C is equal to 31. So you have got the value of C also as 31. Highlight this also. So at the end, write the answer that the required values of A is equal to, A we have got as minus 1, B is equal to 15 and C is equal to 31. So friends, this way we can solve this type of questions. Now move to the another question. So here is the another question. The question is that determine the value of k where k square plus 4k plus 8 and 2k square plus 3k plus 6 and 3k square plus 4k minus 6 are the three consecutive terms of an AP. These three are the consecutive terms of an AP. Then we can say that B is equal to A plus C upon 2. If A, B and C are the consecutive terms of an AP, then the middle term will be calculated as the first term plus second last term upon 2. It means it is the middle term is the average of the first and the last term. So this is the first term, this is the second term, and this is the third term. So the middle term is what? It is the average of the first and the last term. Correct? So we can apply this formula and find the value of k. So here we can say it like this. So first term, so middle term, that is 2k square plus 3k plus 6, that is equal to a plus c, that is k square plus 4k plus 8 plus, I remove this because we will require a space or shift it to the other side. So plus 8, then C is what? 3k square plus 4k plus 6 and divided by 2. So this will be 2k square plus 3k plus 6, which is equal to k square plus k square, 3k square, that will be 4k square. We will add the like terms, then 4k plus 4k, that will be plus 8k, and 8 plus 6, that will be 14, so upon 2. Now multiply by 2 to this side, so it will be 4k square plus 3 to the 6k plus 6 to the 12, which is equal to 4k square plus 8k plus 14. Now here if you see that 4k square and 4k square will get cancelled, take 8k to this side, so it will be 6k minus 8k, which is equal to, take 12 to the other side, so it will be 14 minus 12, so 14 minus 12, that will be 2. And so here 6k minus 8k, that is minus 2k, which is equal to 2. So 2 1s are 2, 2 1s are 2, and therefore k is equal to minus 1. So here we have got the value of k as minus 1. If you take the value of k as minus 1, then this a1, a2 and a3 will be the consecutive terms of an AP. So at the end write the answer, the required value of k is minus 1. So here it finishes because your answer that also has got marks. So examiner gives the marks to this answer also. So always develop the habit of writing the answer also.